Hi everyone, I'm Adam.
And I am Felipe.
And we are developer relations engineers at Google. Over the last few years, we've worked at the intersection of messaging, business development, and AI at Google. So we're excited to be sharing how all these come together through Google's business messages and how you can build a chat experience on search and maps. It's not news that people love messaging each other. We've seen a big uptick in people spending more time on messaging services because of the pandemic. We're also increasingly seeing they want to message brands too. From knowing whether a store is open, to scheduling a pickup, to getting one-to-one expert help to find what they're looking for. Customers today expect speed, simplicity, and convenience, but that's not always what they get. Before we go much further, I want to start by first telling you about something that happened to me recently. Earlier this year, I was on the hunt for a new pair of hiking shoes for a camping trip. I started by reading ratings and reviews online and found a pair I liked, so I looked up the closest store. At the store, the shoes were out of stock, so I called a different store location, but they were out of stock too. I ended up ordering a pair online. My trip was quickly approaching, so I called the service team to request an express delivery instead, but their call center was closed. I checked their website FAQ, but it didn't help. The information I was looking for was nowhere to be found, so I had to wait to get in touch with them. As a consumer, the whole process felt as exhausting as a long run. I was also annoyed that I had to search for the information I was looking for across so many different sources. By the end, I was left disappointed, and it made me question whether I'd buy from them again. So what if things were different? What if customers could message businesses wherever they are, in the moment they need, and get all the information they want in one conversation? Our teams at Google are thinking about precisely this, and we are really excited to share what we've been working on to deliver helpful, timely, and engaging experiences in the moment your customers need help, wherever they are.
With Google's business messages, customers can reach a business from wherever they are in their journey on Google Search, Maps, or any brand-owned channel. Customers can chat with a live agent or with a lifelike AI-powered virtual agent that understands, interacts, and talks in natural ways.
The result is a seamless experience for customers with all the information and questions they're looking for answered in one chat experience, whether it be from a smart AI-powered virtual agent or from a live agent. For businesses, they also have the option to distribute existing real-life agents to other customers at scale.
With billions of searches every day, people look to Google when they want to know something, buy something, or get help doing something. In fact, 93% of all online experiences begin with a search engine. Businesses now have the opportunity to meet customers in the place where they are already searching, like Google Search and Maps, and be available to chat with them throughout their journey. Businesses are able to expand their reach, show up where it matters in a way people prefer, and drive conversions with meaningful, scalable one-on-one conversations, all while reducing the cost typically required to offer this level of personalization.
We've seen a lot of brands benefiting from Google's business messages, from offering customers a personalized experience to increasing conversions and improving ROI. Businesses have been able to drive business impact. Here are just a few of the millions of businesses around the world that are using Google's business messages.
We are excited to talk to you about developing conversational applications on business messages.
There are three simple steps to get started building on business messages. From a bird's eye view, you'll start with a business messages agent, which you can create using the Business Communications Developer Console or using the Business Communications API. Then, you'll design a conversation either on your webhook, passing conversational messages to and from a live agent, or through a chatbot that could be powered by conversational AI through an integration with a tool like Dialogflow.
Finally, when you're happy with how your agent interacts with users, you can launch your business message agents to Google Search and Maps, so the chat button appears in organic results.
The best thing about this conversational platform is that you can lean into the very standard web development best practices that you may already know and love. One way to get started with business messages is to use a web application to receive messages and use the Business Messages API to send messages. In the conversation, it starts with a welcome message, and you can use many interactive elements to display information and guide the user to take actions. This includes rich cards, rich card carousels, rich text with suggested actions, images, authentication with OAuth, and much more. You can send these interactive elements to a conversation with ease using the Business Messages API.
At a high level, business messages conversations will include a welcome message and possibly some conversation starters to help guide the conversation.
One type of message can be a rich text that contains some rich formatting. With that message, you can include suggestions or what many call chips to help the user along the happy path of the conversation.
You can even send typing indicators to let the user know a message is being sent to them. In another type of rich feature, we have a rich card carousel on screen. You can include some actions tied to the card within the carousel. Anywhere a user can start a business message conversation is called an entry point. When the user starts a conversation through an entry point, they can send an inbound message to your web application, and your web application will receive it on a publicly accessible URL we call a webhook. This webhook can be configured using the Business Communications API or the Business Communications Developer Console.
Every message received by your webhook includes a conversation ID so that you can reach back out to the user at a later time. Once you receive that message on your webhook, the ball is in your court. We call this agent control flow, as it is a programmatic flow where you decide whether the conversation is receiving responses by a live agent or a virtual agent. Once the live agent or virtual agent has produced a message, you send that message back to the user as an outbound message using the Business Messages API.
Let's take a look at the messaging flow one more time.
The user sends a message from a Business Messages conversation, which flows through the Business Messages infrastructure and then goes to your webhook. You decide whether your webhook will have automation to generate an outbound message or surface the message from a live agent. You take that outbound message and use the Business Messages API to send that message back to the user. Let's take a deeper look at what requests look like on your webhook. Your webhook can receive requests of varying formats. In most cases, we include meta information about the message, context of the conversation, and if you have it enabled, a Dialogflow response object that contains the response that Dialogflow generated to support an automated conversation.
This payload has all sorts of information to help you better support your users. If the conversation was started from a location-based entry point, we will include a place ID, which is an identifier that can be used to map back to a specific address of the business a user may have been talking to. There are many types of messages or conversational elements available on the conversational interface. No matter what kind of message you send us, you must include a message identifier, a representative object to identify whether the message is coming from a human or a bot, and you may also include a fallback text string, which is presented to a user if their device could not receive a certain type of message. With these basics, you can invoke any of the message types you see on screen and more.
As with any messaging app, a text message is the most basic table stakes feature possible. With our API, you can control the representative who has sent the message to the user. This includes an avatar, the avatar's display name, and of course the contents of the text message. Text messages are great for sharing information, sending follow-on prompts to get more information from the user, and anything that is conveyable through text. If you ever want to emphasize anything in text, we also support rich text formats, which allow you to include markdown-like syntax to bold, italicize, hyperlink, and line break messages. When you send a rich text message, ensure to include the rich text format flag as part of the message payload you send to our APIs.
aside from sending and receiving text messages, you can also prompt a user to respond using what many chat applications call chips. Our platform calls this suggested actions. In its simplest form, a suggested action allows a user to tap a button which sends a message containing the text of the suggested action and also some postback data which can encode something parsable by your application logic.
Suggested actions can also provide more advanced functionality, like invoking the phone calling app with a pre-dialed number, just inviting the user to press call. Or, in another variation, to open up the browser to a specific web page, potentially inviting the user to complete a purchase. In even more complex flows, a suggested action containing an authentication request can support the user to authenticate against another web service, and you can integrate with the external APIs using the user's access token to surface their own personal data in the conversation.
We support images as well. The payload to generate an image is fairly simple. It includes a content info object within an image object. The content info object should include alternative text, a publicly accessible URL to the image, and optionally, a Boolean force refresh flag, which will cache the image when set to false.
Images are, of course, pretty standard in messaging apps. They're great if you're building a conversational app that requires better visual cues, like a furniture store, for instance. Being able to send images of inventory or samples is critical for communication. But sometimes you might want to have a call to action with an image. For example, to prompt a user to learn more or actually purchase an item. In these instances, you can use a rich card. Rich cards are a user interface element that showcases an image, includes a title and a description. The rich card object, of course, contains a title, a description, and a media object, which in turn contains a content info, much like an image, but also includes a height attribute.
And if you have a list of items which include graphics and you want to add call to actions with each item, you can create a list of rich cards or a rich card carousel within the conversational interface. And of course, this applies to rich card carousels as well. All right, so we've talked a bit about the more rich media-based features on the platform. There is also a ton of power under the hood.
Another really great feature on the conversational platform is user authentication with any OAuth 2.0 provider. This will allow you as the developer to trigger API calls on other services on behalf of users with the scopes they've given you access to. Imagine building a shopping experience where a user is putting together a shopping cart in a business messages conversational app supported by Dialogflow conversational AI. And later, they sign onto the website and their shopping cart is persisted because they authenticated within the conversation. Check out the built-in Dialogflow integration. Dialogflow is a natural language understanding platform that makes accessing the power of conversational AI unbelievably easy. With it, you can match natural language to intents that are important for your conversational app, and when a certain intent has been triggered, your web service can behave accordingly. You can activate the built-in Dialogflow integration right within the Business Communications Developer Console.
The possibilities really are endless. If you build a business messages conversational agent as an app instead of a chatbot, you can really create complex flows and support tons of use cases to provide value for users all across the Google ecosystem. All right, so that's just a bit about business messages. It's a very natural extension of the Google ecosystem to provide helpful information where users are already looking. To get started, head on over to our developers webpage and register as a developer today.
Make sure to check out our code samples. We have several repositories of samples that you can pull from. You can also use our conversation design guide, which outlines conversational best practices for specific verticals.
We are excited to see what you build. You can create a business message agent for yourself. If you have a real business on Google or are connected with someone who has a business on Google, you can even get your business message agent verified and launched on Google Search. And when you're ready, integrate with Dialogflow to get the power of conversational AI baked right into your conversational experiences on business messages.
Here are some additional resources.
To learn more about business messages, check out our website, businessmessages.google, our developer portal, and definitely don't forget our code labs.
Thanks for joining us on this exploration of the Business Messages platform.